Now I am going to tell you how to solve this problem. Already I have solved one problem related to the stresses calculation of a beam. So this is your second problem. Now what you have to do in such type of problem? First you have to find out all these terms. What is the P? What is the area? What is the bending moment due to dead load? What is the bending moment due to live load? What is the Z of the section? What is the eccentricity? You have to collect all these terms and then you have to put these terms in formula and find out the top and bottom pair of stresses. Okay, so I will read this question. This question was asked in May 2017 for 17 marks. Okay. Pre-stressed concrete beam of rectangular section 375 by 750 mm. Span of 212 meter. The effective pre-stressing force is 1520 kN at an eccentricity of 150 mm. Eccentricity is directly given. Okay. So, if the eccentricity, this word is present in the question, so you have to assume that that eccentricity is constant throughout the beam. Okay. The dead load 7 kN per meter, live load 12.5 kN per meter, determine the extreme fiber stresses in concrete. Okay. So, you have to consider the three cases here. Okay. One is at the end of the section. You have to find out the stresses at the end of the section. Then at the mid span of the section, at mid of the section with action of live load, you have to consider, at the mid section of without action of live load, and at the mid section with the action of live load, that you have to consider three cases. So first I will write down all these given data here. First I will write down all this given data. So it is the 375 by 750 mm is the dimensions. Okay. So span of beam is 12 meter. Then effective pre-stressing force is 1520 kN. Okay. And the eccentricity is 150 mm. I am going to collect this data here. Okay. Now what is the dead load? So dead load is 7 kN per meter. Live load is 12.5 kN per meter. Okay. Now you have to find out extreme fiber stresses. Now how to find out it? First, at end section, remember this, at mid section without action of live load and at mid section with the action of live load. Okay. Now I will write this. First you have to collect all these things. Okay. So what is the first thing you have to draw? The cross section. So this is a cross section view of the beam. I will sketch. Okay. So this is the YY axis. This is the XX axis. And again you have to draw the longitudinal section. Okay. So this is the one support. This is another support. The span of beam is 12 meter. Span of beam is that 12 meter. Okay. So this is the CG of concrete. So this is the CD of concrete. Okay. Sorry. Now the tendon is having a eccentricity 150 mm. Here directly eccentricity is given. That means eccentricity is the distance between the CD of concrete and CD of steel, CD of tendon. So this is the location of your tendon. This is the location of your tendon. Okay. You can fix anywhere. So now I will fix here. And the effective pre-stressing force is 1520 applied. Okay. Now it having a dead load and live load. It having a dead load and live load both. okay, and the width of beam is 375 and depth of beam is 750 mm. These are the given values. Now to find out the stresses. So for calculation of stresses, you need this term: area, pre-stressing force, bending moment due to dead load, bending moment due to live load. Okay. Then Z top, Z bottom, all these things first you have to collect and put in the formula. So now first, what is the area of the section? It is 375 by 750. 375 by 750 is the area of the section. If you want to calculate this, calculate 375 by 750. The value is, I will write here, the value is 281.25 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. So this is the area of the section, isn't it? Now you have to find out the Z. Okay, so what is the Z? Z is the sectional modulus. Z is the sectional modulus. How is calculated Z? So Z is always calculated as I by Y. Formula is I by Y. So what is the R? R, always you have to consider R with respect to x-axis. So x-axis is 1/12 BD cube divided by Y is always depth by 2. Always depth by 2. So it is 1/12. Width is 375. Depth is 750 cube. Divided by Y is 750 divided by 2. So from that you get the Z. Okay. So 1/12 into 375 into 750 cube divided by 750 by 2. The answer is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. Directly you get in mm cube. Directly you get this in mm cube, isn't it? Now already we have calculated area, then section modulus. Now what you have to find out? The bending moment due to dead load and bending moment due to live load you have to find out. So the beam is simply supported. So this is the line diagram. The beam is simply supported. The span of the beam is 12 meter. Span of the beam is 12 meter and the dead load is 7 kN per meter. Dead load is 7 kN per meter, isn't it? So beam is simply supported with 12 meter span. So dead load is 7. So what is the bending moment at end? Bending moment at this end, bending moment at this end is 0. Now what is the bending moment at mid span? At mid, it is WL square by 8, obviously it is 7 into 12 square by 8. Okay, so 7 into 12 into 12 by 8, it is 126 kilonewton meter. The value is 126 kilonewton meter. Now same thing, due to the live load 12.5 kilonewton meter, due to live load you have to calculate the bending moment due to dead load and live load separate, because in this question separate dead load and live load is given, as well as you have to consider the stresses condition with live load and without live load. So that's why you have to find out the bending moment due to dead load is separate, bending moment due to live load is separate. Okay, but in previous problem the total load is given, so there is no separation of dead load and live load. In previous problem, we have considered the total load. Okay, so now this calculation is related to dead load. Okay, now if you consider the live load, what is the bending moment due to end? It is 0. Bending moment at end always 0 due to any load when the beam is simply supported. Okay. Now what is the bending moment at mid? It is WL square by 8, simple. So it is 12.5 into 8 square by 8. So 12.5 into 8 into 8 by 8, it is 100 kilonewton meter. 100 kilonewton meter, isn't it? So these are the calculations. So already all these things are we have collected. Okay. Now you have to make list and finally to put these things in the calculation of stress, isn't it? Isn't it? So already we have the area. Then what is the value of z? It is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6 cube. Okay. Now bending moment due to dead load at midspan is 126 kilonewton meter. This bending moment is at midspan, obviously. Now bending moment due to live load is 100 kilonewton meter. Again it is at midspan, and all other things are, we know these things. Okay, now I want to rub this. Now I have to consider the cases. Isn't it? Is it clear to you? Now what is the first case? Stresses at end of beam. You have to find out the top and bottom fiber stresses at end of beam. Top and bottom fiber stresses at end of beam, isn't it? I will check it at end section. Okay. Now the top fiber stress is P by A plus bending moment due to dead load by Z top plus bending moment due to live load by Z top minus P into E by Z top. So this is formula. Okay. First you write down all this formula, all terms, and you have to cut the terms which is not applicable for that case. Okay. Now what is the P? P is 1520 into 10 raised to 3. Already we know this P. What is the area? Area is P, already we have calculated, it is 281.25 into 10 raised to 3. Okay. Now at we are going to calculate the stresses at end section. That means at this location, at this location. Okay, at this location, at this location. So bending moment at end, for simply supported beam is always zero. So this term is zero. Okay, again bending moment to live load, this term is zero. But this term is present because at end section the eccentricity is there. So this eccentricity is 150 mm is given in question. At end section, eccentricity is there. So this term is present. So it is 1520 into 10 raised to 3 multiplied by 150 P into E. And what is the Z? Z is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. So this is the stress calculation. 1520 into 10 to 3 divided by 281.25 into 10 raised to 3. So I will calculate again. 1520 into 10 to 3 divided by 281.25 into 10 raised to 3. Okay. The value is 5.40. These two terms are 0. 1520 into 10 raised to 3 into 150 divided by 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. Again, this term is 6.48. So, what is the top fiber stress? So, it is 5.40 minus 6.48. This value is minus 1.08 newton per mm square. 1.08 newton per mm square. So, this is the top fiber stress. Simple, you have to add and subtract this term. Already we have done this concept in song 2, that and bending stresses. Okay. What is the bottom fiber stress? वाटर बाय मोसेस फार्मूला इज सेम, पी बाय ए माइनस बेंडिंग मोमेंट ड्यू टू डेड लोड डिवाइडेड बाय जेड बॉटम माइनस बेंडिंग मोमेंट ड्यू टू लाइव लोड डिवाइडेड बाय जेड बॉटम प्लस पी इंटू ई बाय जेड बॉटम इजंट इट. नाउ वी नो दिस टर्म E by A is 5.40. This term is 0, this term is 0. What is this term? This term is plus 6.48. We know this term. We know this term. Because Z top and Z bottom is same here. Because the section is symmetrical section. Why? This Y is same. This Y is same. Okay. So, 5.40 plus 6.48, the value is 11.88 Newton per mm square. So this is the stress value. Okay, little bit I will rough this thing. I want to reduce this figure. Okay. So these are the loading condition. This is time. Okay. Now what we do? Top fiber stress is minus 1.08. How to plot it? So top fiber stress is minus 1.08. You have to plot left side. 1.08 megapascal. Again, bottom fiber stress is 11.88 megapascal. Scale this figure. So this is plus, this is minus. So this is stress diagram for this case. This is stress diagram for this case. Isn't it? One case is complete. Now, what we do? The second case is, what is the second case? Second case is, at mid span section without the action of LILO, stresses at mid span section without action of LILO. Okay. So we know the formula. Top fiber stress is P by A plus bending moment due to dead load by Z top plus bending moment due to LILO by Z top minus P into E by Z top. First you try to write all this formula. Okay. Now put the terms. The pre-stressing force is 1520 into 10 raised to 3. The area is 281.25 into 10 raised to 3. Okay. Plus the stresses at mid span section without the action of lie load. That means you have to consider dead load. So what is the dead load? At mid span section, there is a development of bending moment due to dead load. Okay. So to put this term, you have to consider this term. Bending moment due to dead load is 126. So it is 126 into 10 raised to 6 divided by what is dead. Dead is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. Isn't it? This term is present. Now you have to neglect this term. Plus, neglect this term because in question also it clearly mentioned that without action of lie load. So minus pre-stressing force 1520 into 10 raised to 3, eccentricity is 150. We are going to calculate the stresses at mid span. So to consider the eccentricity at mid span, it is 150. Okay. Now Z is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. So we know the first term, already we have calculated that first term. Okay. It is 5.40. Now the second term. It is 126 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, so this is 3.58, and last term is 1520 into 10 raised to 3 into 150 divided by 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. It is 6.48. Take the summation. 5.40 plus 3.58 minus 6.48. It is 2.5 megapascal positive. Okay. Now what is the bottom fiber stress? What is the bottom fiber? Same term you have to put here. P by A, but term signs are not. Dead load divided by Z bottom minus bending moment due to live load divided by Z bottom and plus P into E by Z bottom. So we know the first term. It is 5.40. It is 5.40. Now bending moment due to dead load you have to consider. It is 3.58 because Z top and Z bottom is same. Z top and Z bottom is same due to symmetrical section, and this term is neglected because in case it is directly mentioned that you have to calculate the stresses without action of fly load, and plus 6.48. So what is the value? 5.40 minus 3.5 plus 6.48. So this is 8.3. So total it is in compression. So how it is plotted? So this is your baseline. This is your baseline. At top fiber stress it is 2.5 positive. 2.5 megapascal. And bottom fiber stress is 8.3 megapascal. So this is the stress diagram for this case. This is stress diagram for this case. Is that it? Is it clear to you? Now in last case what did you do? Now in last case what did you do? I will calculate this case in this portion of the board. Okay. Now third case. Calculate stresses at mid-span with action of live load. With the action of light. So this is your third case. Okay. Now what is the top fiber stress? You know the formula. P by A plus bending moment into dead load by Z top plus bending moment into live load divided by Z top minus P into E by Z top. We are going to calculate the stresses at mid-span. At mid-span. Okay. So P by A. This term is ready. 5.40. Okay, P by A, it is 5.40 plus bending moment due to dead load by Z top. This term is ready, it is 3.58. It is 3.58. Now to consider this term, because in this case it is directly mentioned that you have to consider the action of fly load. So you have to plus the bending moment due to fly load is 100. 100 into 10 raised to 6. What is the Z top? Z top is 35.15 into 10 raised to 6, and finally also we know this term, it is 6.48. It is 6.48. So what is the final value? So 100 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 35.15 into 10 raised to 6. Particularly I will write down here. So particularly this term is, I will write down here, particularly this term is 2.84. This term is, so I want to clear it here. Okay, this term is 2.84. So you have to take, consider all these terms. First is 5.40, second is 3.58,
third is 2.84 and fourth is minus 6.48. This is 5.34 megapascal, isn't it? 5.34 megapascal. Okay. So this is your top fiber stress. Okay. Now, what you have to do for the bottom fiber stress? What you do for the bottom fiber stress? So how the bottom fiber stress is calculated? Bottom fiber stress, like write down here like this, bottom. Okay, so first is P by A minus bending moment due to dead load by Z bottom minus bending moment due to live load by Z bottom plus P into E by Z bottom. Okay, so like this you have to write down. All these terms are ready here. Okay, so first is 5.40. We know this term, 5.40. Second is 3.58. Third is 2.84. And last is 6.48. Okay, look here. The first term is 5.40. Second term is 3.58. Third term is 2.84. But you have to change the signs. So what is the final result? It is 5.40 minus 3.58 minus 2.84 plus 6.48, it is 5.46. It is 5.46 megapascal, and both are positive. Okay, so to put here, top fiber stress is 5.34 megapascal, bottom fiber stress is 5.46 megapascal. Okay, just you have to show like this. So this is stress distribution at mid span. Stress distribution at mid span when live load is considered, isn't it?